Yo, you ever try to send a text about somebody and then you end up texting that person instead by accident? Me neither. Intro. Yo, what up? My name is Vladimir Richer from ChaseAndWriter.com. And in today's video, I'm going to answer some questions that I get posed on YouTube. The first video that I made was a few months ago. I really want to make these videos at least once a month because I get a ton of questions. If you were to look at my videos, I get so many questions on every video, and sometimes I don't get a chance to answer all of them. Not to mention that a lot of times you don't even get notified that you have a question. So I'm going to take this opportunity to answer some of those questions, and let's start with the first one. The first question is from Kevin Mickle. And he goes, I'm looking for a video on your channel showing what your first shoe should be, color, style to build off of. Wanting to step up my game to do it right. Can you help? That's an excellent question, Kevin, and I would say it depends on your dress code and how often you wear a suit. If you wear a suit 5 days a week, for example, I would definitely recommend some black cap to Oxfords to start with. Black cap to Oxfords aren't the most versatile per se, because you can't really dress them down. Black cap to Oxford look really weird with sport coats and trousers, for example. But certain occasions only call for those type of shoes. So it's very important that you have that type of shoe in your wardrobe. But if you're somebody that dress down more often, like sport coats and trousers similar to what I'm wearing right now, then you can't really go wrong with a pair of brown suede tassel loafers. You can't really wear them with a serious suit. Like, I wouldn't wear a pair of loafers with, let's say, a pinstripe suit or like a dark navy suit or something like that. But you can typically wear them with more casual suits such as a linen suit, flannel suits, and they go with every single out trousers and sport coats combination that you can think of. So I would say it really depends on your wardrobe. If you wear a lot of suits, then I would recommend a black cap to Oxford first, and the second I would recommend some dark brown shoes, you know what I mean? But if you're more casual, then I would say a pair of suede tassel loafers in dark brown. Let's get to the second question. The next question comes from Jay Rodriguez. He left me this question on a shirt video that I made from Spear and McKay. And he goes, are their white shirts see-through or thick and solid? Pause. The thing with white shirts, even if it's not really a see-through shirt, if you're wearing a white undershirt, it's going to see through the shirt for the most part. To answer your question directly, the Spear and McKay shirts that I unboxed in my custom shirt video, if you haven't seen it, I'll link it somewhere up here. I'll also include it in the description. In that video, the white shirt that I unboxed, I wouldn't really call it see-through, but if you're wearing a white undershirt, it's still going to show through. So that's why I always recommend, whenever you're wearing a white shirt, to always wear a gray undershirt underneath the white shirt. Because if you're wearing a white undershirt, then you're going to be able to see the white undershirt under the white shirt, regardless if it's see-through or not. The next question comes from Pernell Parker, and he wanted to know, is the no-show socks with loafers still a good look? That was left from the unboxing video that I did recently of my first pair of loafers. Personally, I'm not going to be wearing my loafers with no-show socks, but there's absolutely nothing wrong with it, man. I really feel like when I'm wearing my loafers, it's the time for me to start wearing some really colorful socks. I'm not talking about striped socks. As you guys know, I really hate striped socks, but solid color socks like green socks, purple socks, burgundy socks, you know, those type of sock colors really go good with loafers. I mean, I feel like whenever you're wearing loafers, that means probably dress down a little bit, and that's the time to kind of have fun with your socks. Personally, I always wear colorful loafers with my socks. So now that I've been wearing loafers for years, I just got my first pair of loafers the other day, but every time I rocked it a couple times so far, it's been with some colorful socks. But yeah, man, to answer your question, there's nothing wrong with no-show socks, especially if you live in a hot climate. Go ahead and rock your no-show socks, man. Nothing wrong with that at all. Next question. The next question comes from Iron Armor, and he goes, I wanted to ask, do you have any other blogger that you read? Permanent Style, Parisian Gentleman? Yeah, man, I definitely read some other bloggers. The first blog I remember reading is Put This On. Reading Put This On was the first time I ever heard of a collar gap. So I really learned a lot from that blog. And then I went from Put This On to eventually I was on Style Forum like all the time. I mean, that's not really a blog, that's more of a forum. That's probably where I learned most of what I know. And Permanent Style is a really great blog that talk about classic menswear. And I definitely read that blog as well. The next question comes from Juan Reyes, my guy. He goes, dear Mr. Richer, what kind of grenadine would you buy first? Gazafina or Gazagrossa? Now, if you're not familiar with grenadine ties, grenadine is a silk fabric out of Italy, and it comes in two different options. Gazzafina has really subtle patterns, where the Gazza Grossa, the patterns are definitely more obvious. Personally, I feel like the Gazzafina is definitely dressier because the patterns aren't as pronounced. Versus the Grossa, even from a little bit of a distance, you can definitely see that it's different than just a regular solid tie. But to really answer your question, I don't really think that there's a wrong answer here. I think the most important thing when it comes to a grenadine tie is to really think about what color that you're going to get first. Personally, I feel like you should have a black one and you should have a navy one, and then you can play around. You can probably get a green, you can get a burgundy. But I think that the solid black and the solid navy are the two that I would recommend. But as far as the Gazza Grossa or the Gazza Fina, I really feel like it's just a matter of personal choice. You know what I mean? Personally, I like the Fina, but there's no wrong answer. Next question. This one comes from Christopher Wright. He goes, what about flannel trousers in other colors? I will get gray for sure, but I was wondering why there isn't so much info out there about non-gray flannel trousers. They don't look as nice in other colors. I was thinking of sand, tan, or light brown colors. That's a really good question, Christopher. I think that the reason why people really talk about gray flannel trousers is because they're the most versatile color that you can have. And also, when you're talking about gray, there are so many different shades. So you can get like a light gray, you can get a medium gray, and then you can get a charcoal gray. So typically, when you're talking about trousers, you're going to be wearing them with sport coats, cardigans, polo shirts, those type of things. And gray is just a really versatile and classy color. I think that's the reason why guys talk about gray a lot. But personally, I do have them in other colors as well. Actually, I just got two flannel trousers to get ready for the fall from Spear and McKay. I can't even really remember now exactly what colors they are. Eventually, I'll make a video on them just to show you that, yeah, you can have different color trousers, flannel trousers, as opposed to just gray. But gray just happened to be the most versatile. But those colors that you mentioned are also great colors, and I would highly recommend them. I think that brown flannel is something that's very slept on. Brown flannel is a beautiful color, and brown, just like gray, has many different variations. Even a brown flannel suit is a really good look. It's not something that you see too often. I think depending on the color of the brown, if it goes with your skin tone, it's a really, really good look, man. So yeah, I do recommend all those colors that you mentioned, but gray just happened to be the most versatile and the most common. All right, the next question comes from Hugo Lizardi, and he goes, what do you think about hole cuts? I'm looking at Carminas or Magnanis. I like Paul Evans, but wouldn't buy them. Personally, I don't love hole cuts, man. And that's only because hole cuts, if you guys are not familiar, hole cuts is really just one piece of leather for the most part. And when you're looking at the vamp, there's really no cap there to minimize the creasing. I find that hole cuts really, really crease a lot. But it's really just a personal choice, man. A lot of people prefer hole cuts over black cap to Oxfords as their dress issue. And that's cool, you know what I mean? There's nothing wrong with that. It's just me, I really don't like hole cuts because I feel like they crease too much. And aesthetically, I also don't feel like they look as good as a plain cap to Oxford. But that's just a personal thing, man. There's absolutely nothing wrong with them. If you like your hole cuts, definitely feel free to get them. And as far as the brands that you mentioned, I would say that Carmina is the best brand on there. I don't even think that Carmina and Magnani and Paul Evans are even in the same league. I know you didn't really ask me about which brand do I prefer, but I'm just gonna take this opportunity to say that out of those three brands, I would definitely recommend Carmina over those other two brands. The next question comes from Giorgio Sianaku. Do you happen to still have the 20% for Spear and McKay? I've been getting this question a lot the past couple months, so I just want to address it real quick. Unfortunately, the 20% code from Spear and McKay is no longer valid. Spear and McKay upgraded their website back in April, and when they did that, it broke the referral program. It was definitely an accident. They didn't really mean for it to happen, but that's exactly what happened. So ever since April, I've been getting a lot of comments with guys telling me that the 20% code is not working. And unfortunately, we're in July and it's still not working. The good thing is Spear and McKay is already priced pretty well, so I would still highly recommend them. For example, right now I'm wearing a Spear and McKay linen sport coat. I'm wearing a Spear and McKay button-down shirt. I'm also wearing a Spear and McKay fresco trousers. So I highly recommend Spear and McKay, even though 20% code is not currently active, but as soon as it's back, I'll mention it in one of my videos. The next question comes from Benjamin Kosravi. As always, great video, but I selfishly would love to see more videos on suits and sport coats. Are you planning on becoming a shoe only channel? I'm not planning on becoming a shoe on the channel, although most people do know me because of shoes. Shoes were my first love when I got into menswear. I feel like shoes are the most important aspect of menswear, because as in building a house, like I like to say, you want to start with the foundation. It's the same with your wardrobe, you definitely want to start with your shoes. And also a lot of the brands that reach out to me for collaborations are usually shoe brands. And I do have a ton of content coming about shoes in the next couple months, because I have a bunch of shoes coming, but I'll still be sprinkling in other videos that have nothing to do with shoes, you know what I mean? And I love all of menswear. You can expect to see everything on this channel that has to do with classic menswear. All right, the next question comes from KT, and he goes, Vlad, we need a content schedule. What do you think? Now, this is a good question, and I've been wanting to address this for a while. Now, I know when it comes to YouTube, a lot of creators have a schedule so that their subscribers already know exactly when to expect a video. And with me, it hasn't been like that. Really, since I started the channel, I never really had a schedule. To be completely honest with you, I would love to have a schedule. And unfortunately, because of the way my life is set up, I can't really commit to a schedule. That's my fault too, because I know that in the beginning, I mentioned that I wanted to put out a video a week and sometimes two, and I haven't been holding my end of the bargain. And for that, I apologize. I try to make the videos and put them out as much as I can, really. And as you guys know, I'm not a full-time YouTuber. I have a full-time job. I have children, and it's not always easy for me to make these videos, you know what I'm saying? But no excuses, I do want to make more videos, and I'm really trying to find a way to do that. And also, I know a lot of guys been asking me to make more fit videos, to like where I'm showing exactly what I'm wearing as opposed to just talking about it. So that's something that I'm going to be doing as well. So you can expect more videos in the next couple months, but it's really hard for me to really say how many videos. So no, unfortunately, I can't really give you a schedule now, but expect more videos, man. That's pretty much all I can tell you. And I really appreciate you guys for sticking out with me. And hopefully one day I can just be a full-time YouTuber and this will be my job. But for right now, once a week, sometimes I can't even meet that, is the best that I can do, but I'm working to get better on it, I promise. The next question comes from JCA, and he goes, was the water glass grabbing a reference to an orange wimp? No comment. Next question. And the next question comes from Ryder Richey. Sounds familiar. He goes, Daddy, when are you gonna put me in a video? I don't know, that's a good question. Chase really knocked it out of the park. I just don't know if Ryder's ready for that kind of action yet, you know what I mean? It's not easy to get in front of this camera, man. So, I mean, I put him on the channel before where he was doing his little flips, but now he wants to have like a talking part. I don't know if he's ready for that yet, but let me know in the comments if you guys want to see him and I'll make it happen. Hit the thumbs up if you like this video. Subscribe, or everybody gonna think that you're a hater. And I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.